shall be done.
These are the ruins. The broken alluvian should be around here.
Oh, I'm so excited!
You don't seem to be that pleased to be out of the tower, Finn. I thought most mages wanted to be free.
Why? Just to be outside? Do you see this splotch here on my rope? That's mud. There's no mud in the tower. I miss being cozy and dry.
I shall do it.
Perhaps the dog needs some privacy?
Oh, hey, hello.
I have a good feeling about this.
It's contagious, do you?
As a child, I would break the fingers of those who poked me needlessly. Just saying.
More enemies ahead. Be done.
As a child, I would break the fingers of those who poked me needlessly. Just saying.
shall be done. As you say, it is begun.
The Illuvians. It's magnificent. And broken. Mostly broken. We have the shard of the Illuvian, but we still need the light of our Lathan. We should head to Kadash Tide when you're ready to leave. Yes, I'm here.
As a child, I would break the fingers of those who poked me needlessly. Just saying. So you've never been outdoors? Till now?
I have been. But just don't care much for it. We had to do stretching exercises. I got sweaty. There was dirt. During my apprenticeship, they thought getting fresh air and exercise at least once a week would do us good.
Fresh air and sunlight is good for you.
You know what feels fresh air in the summer? Mosquitoes! Hungry for sweet, untested mage flesh!
Well, when you put it that way...
Luckily, it didn't last long. One day, an apprentice made a break for it. Jumped off the dock and started swimming for the shore. The Templars couldn't jump in after him. Not with the armor on. Finally found him a week later. We stopped having to go out after that. That mage, Anders, never stopped trying to escape, though. Haven't heard from him since his last attempt. Hard to breathe with all this stone around me. I hope this is all in my head. Wait, why did we stop? Is this Kadash Tide? Right, so I've been going through my old notes. And I came across this footnote. Apparently, the elves would magically conceal relics of great significance, thus shielding them from unworthy eyes. And given what the Tevinters did, I'd say they count as unworthy.
You don't say.
That's my hypothesis. But they might just be buried in the ground, too. Actually, that's very likely. It looks like Kadash Tide was built on the ruins of Catalash. The lights of our Lathan could be miles below us.
I liked the other theory more.
If the elves concealed the relics with magic, only the blood of their kin will reveal them. Ariane, we need your blood.
Excuse me?
Just a few drops, that's it. Blood doesn't power the spell, it's just a... component. It's certainly a gray area, so let's just keep this between the three of us, shall we? Four of us. You share the same blood as the Arlathan elves, so you're the only one this enchantment might recognize.
Fine. Just because hearing that gets me all tingly. A few drops.
I'll be gentle. My spell will reveal vortices of magic. Standing in them should allow us to see the energy being drawn to the relics, which will lead us to them. Once we reach the influence of the lights of Arlathan, Ariane's blood will unveil them. But we have to be close.
Going well? manner of beast is this?
Interesting. This carving over here is an old dwarven dialect. If you find more writing like this, I could probably translate it.
Perhaps the dog needs some privacy?
A magical vortex. We can use it to reveal the energy flowing towards the light of Alathen. Do you see it? Can you follow the path?
I always thought dwarves must be dull without magic. But this place is amazing.
Dash on!
Being drawn to the light of Alathen.
It shall be done.
I think something's here. The statue was capable of being literal. The Kadash dwarves didn't even know they once had elves living here. Wouldn't this be remarkable enough to record in the memories? Dwarven history when I return. Ooh, what's that? Fascinating. Where's my note? Oh, I'll look at that later.
Strange to think of the dwarves giving shelter, in this darkness, to the elves who fled Arlathan.
Attention to where they're going.
Thank you.
torches. Still burning after thousands of years. Magic. Special fuel. Perhaps the design of the sconces. Hey, wait up!
Here could lead us to where Arlith and once stood. If you hate the outside so much, why come with us?
Couldn't pass up a chance to learn more about the ancient elves and the mirrors. Besides, the company is good.
Thanks.
I meant the dog. Pay attention to where they're going.
Finn!
Sorry.
There it is!
Pay attention to where they're going.
Oh, what we could do if we hadn't lost this magic.
We're seeing the magical energy being drawn to the light of our lantern.
I shall do it. It's true, then. A small group of elves took refuge here. shall be done.
Kalsharok destroyed Khad Halash. The dwarves slaughtered their own because they feared the Tevinter Imperium. Despicable. People could not have been comfortable hiding under so much stone. Let me just get this again. Your name is Florian Phineas...
Horatio Aldebrandt, Esquire. Can't forget the Esquire. Father insisted.
Did your parents hate you?
No. They adore me. In fact, I'm sure my name is a result of overwhelming love replacing good sense.
Be done.
And they're showing us the way.
I guess.
Here it comes!
Shard of the Illuvian, and the lights of Alathen. Now all we have to do is scry for an unbroken mirror. I saw a suitable place for the ritual not too far from here.
Prepare yourself. The ritual may attract unwanted attention. You'll have to protect me.
Here we go!
You dying!
It has begun. It has begun.
Am I bleeding? Oh, look, a rip in my robe.
What happened to Ariane? Give us your blood. Who cares if it hurts?
It's my blood. That's different. I've pinpointed another Illuvian. It's in the Dragonbone Wastes. The Tevinters probably moved it there to see if the ancient Dragonbones could enhance the Illuvian's power. Might be hidden, or only appear to those who know its location. We examine the mirror. It might give clues to what Morrigan's doing. If she's looking for the Illuvians as well, she might even be there. Shall we? call that which covers a tree? We're here. Keep your eyes open for dragons and mirrors. Dragon worshiper before? Not much for small talk, are they?
Why would anyone worship a dragon?
Dragons are big, powerful, and they breathe fire! Some people are easily impressed. Remind me not to step in that.
Gain the
Is that
a Varterel? It can't be. They're only legends. It is said they were rock and tree, wind and rain, given form and breath by the elven gods to protect their people.
To protect their people? Then why does it look like it's going to eat you?
Thank you.
Illuviang. And it's glowing. We should...
I think she's expecting you. Ask her about our book.
No further, please. One more step and I leave. For good this time. I assume you know what this is. I have gone to great lengths to find and activate this portal. Give me reason and I use it, and you will not be able to follow. To another place. Beyond this world and beyond the Fade. But this portal can only be used once more. Achieving even this much was difficult. I remained to see if it was truly you. I had to know. Tell me. Why did you come? So you chase me all this way to offer help? I will never understand you, and you will never understand me. Yes, I suppose we did. I would not even know where to begin explaining. I did not betray you. I left, just as I said I would. I fought with you. I put my life on the line to aid your quest. And then the battle came too soon. I had no choice but to go to you. And I did not want to see you die. And here you stand, alive. So do not speak to me of betrayal. He is safe, and beyond your reach. All you need to know is that the child is an innocent. He knows nothing of the destiny that lies before him. Because the child is yours, I understand. I will not share my plan with you. I dare not. If your trust is insufficient, then your anger will have to do. My plan is to leave and prepare the child for what is to come. Such preparation requires time and power. I must have both if I am to be successful. More than this, I dare not say, even to you. Then allow me to provide you a warning. 'Tis Flemeth you should beware of, not me. Hunt her if you hunt anyone. My mother has tricked her way past death and more. She is no more finished than I am. I thought I knew what Flemeth planned. I thought what she craved was immortality, and yet I was wrong. So very wrong. She is no blood mage, no abomination. She is not even truly human. The ritual was but a means to an end, a herald for what is to come. Change is coming to the world. Many fear change and will fight it with every fiber of their being. But sometimes, change is what they need most. Sometimes, change is what sets them free. What I want is unimportant now. I cannot tarry longer. The time has come for me to go. Not if you are fortunate. There is one last thing I must tell you. If you will allow me. I left you a gift. The Dalish book is there. And something you will find of great interest. Goodbye, my friend.